What's up, YouTubers? It is Keith right here. You guys making another video. Today is the 20th of July. It's about 9:30 in the evening. I'll first and foremost want to say I give my condolences to the family and friends and victims of the Colorado massacre shooting happening at the theater in Colorado at the Dark Knight premiere. You guys, I want to first and foremost give a shout out to N7777. I'm a sub to his channel, you guys, and he brought this video to my attention. You guys, I want to give a shout out to him. What's up, buddy? Thanks for sharing that with me. And I'm going to make a video response. This is a video response to that about the Colorado shooting. You guys, a lot of people are making video responses about what happened in Colorado last night, early morning, this morning. Changed the channel, made a video about it. The Haas USMC, Photo Helix, want to say what's up to you, buddy. He also made a video. And a couple other people that I'm subscribed to made video responses as well. Even Nuttin' Fancy even shared his thoughts about the Colorado shooting, and he emphasized the importance of concealed carry gun holders, and he brought up his views on that as well, the sheepdogs and all that stuff like that. Well, you guys, I want to first, of course, address my respects to the fallen, but I want to say this, you guys. This stinks to high heaven for a number of reasons. And it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out why or to ask questions. Some seriously devoted questions. Now, first of all, this video might be a little lengthy, but, you know, if you don't like it, kick rocks. But I'm going to address a couple topics that you need to ask yourself. Everything, you guys, as far as symbology and meaning, I went into that in another video, you guys, recently, about the Rick Clay and the 2012 Summer Olympics, about symbology and numerology and all that stuff. Now, I've studied that for years, but I want to show you how you can see through it all, and it all intertwines and kind of relates to each other. First of all, Colorado. Colorado itself as a state holds high value to the people of the elite. All your major entities, as far as intelligence, some military branches, and the like, are all centrally located in Colorado. You got the U.S. Air Force, you got a NASA project, you have the FBI, CIA, and the list goes on and on, are relocating to Colorado, the Rockies. So there's a lot of entities already there in Colorado. Now, Colorado, as far as Colorado, I'm gonna jump all over the place, but I'm gonna kind of try and stay together. But now, Colorado, okay, so the state itself has a whole lot of meaning. You got the Denver Airport there you want to talk about symbology and hidden, you know, messaging and all that stuff. Man, that's a candy land for someone looking for that stuff. But anyhow, Colorado, Denver Airport's over there in Colorado as well. But it happened in Aurora. Now, the word Aurora, when you think about that, what does that mean? It means light. We told you all about that, light. Aurora means heavenly light, stuff like that. Okay, so that's just one other meaning. The other thing is that this happened in a theater at the premiere of Batman Dark Knight Rises, okay? So when you think of rises, okay, what do you think of? You think of the sun rises, okay? The sun. So there you go. Sun, okay, rises, an uprising. It's all subliminal messaging. You know, when you think of a dark night, you think of this, you know, and the guy, the gunman was wearing black, you know, dark, and he was by himself, a vigilante or a terrorist, whatever. Now, Batman, the character Batman, wears black, dark. He rolls by himself, okay? He has advanced weapons and technology. He rolls by himself. And then in the movie, I haven't seen it, but it's Hollywood, okay? And I know that Hollywood is just infiltrated with symbology. Now, in the preview, if you've seen the movie, there's this trailer of the stadium, a football stadium, and a running back is running with the football, and he's dodging and bobbing and weaving, and you see in the shot behind him, the stadium floor, the field, is collapsing. There's bombs set around it, everything like that. Well, what do we have coming up? We have the Summer Olympics, right? Huge stadium, people viewing the game, spectators, and a terrorist act happens at that football game. This is in the movie, Dark Knight Rises, okay? Boom, so there's a terrorist act on a sporting event by spectators, viewed by thousands, millions, whatever. Okay, so that's implemented in the movie itself, Dark Knight Rises, okay? So that's just the movie, okay? So this cat walks in an emergency exit. Now, they say he kicked the door open. Well, that's not true. Emergency exits open outward. They don't open inward. It's physically impossible to kick an emergency door in. It's impossible. Now, an emergency door, as you guys know, emergency doors, what happens when you open them? An emergency alarm goes off. Okay? That's what happens. Now, and then when an emergency goes off in a movie theater, the lights come on, the exits are illuminated, and the people are ushered out the theater. Having said that, that's normal events that happen, but this didn't happen. So this guy somehow kicked the emergency exit door in, started throwing CS gas, and just started blasting away. I guess he was armed with an AK or a AR-15, and then a Glock pistol. You guys, I'm gonna tell you right now, this stinks to high heaven. Now, first of all, back on the symbology, this happened at the movie theater. I think it was 16. The theater was 16 in rural California. The theater where the Dark Knight Rises was in Theater 9. So there you go. The Theater 9 at the local 16 theater. Now you have 9 right there. Theater 9. Dark Knight Rises premiere. Okay. So you have that, right? This cat walks in. Now, I'm going to tell you guys right now. I'm a combat veteran, and there is so many of us out there that are combat veterans nowadays, okay? This isn't like it was in the late 80s where the combat veterans are scarcity, because the only thing that recently happened that was like Grenada. Nowadays, I mean, there's combat veterans all over the place. With that being said, this guy is by himself. He walks in the theater and shoots 71 people? You know how many magazine dumps that is? With that being said, he's by himself. If he goes to make a magazine dump, where's all the concealed carry? Where's all the sheepdogs? Where's all the concealed carry permit holders? Colorado isn't like California. Man, people can have their concealed carry. They can pack a sidearm. And that's close quarters. A movie theater is close quarters. I'm not talking about the LA gun shootout robbery with the two bandits who are armed with AK-47s and a whole division of a police department. I'm talking about a movie theater packed with civilians. I guarantee you there was some combat vets in there. And I guarantee you that there was CCW holders. No one drew their firearm. That just boggles my mind. that this guy was able to have, I don't know how many magazine dumps he had. But this guy wasn't prior service military. This guy was some PhD dropout, which you gotta, he was going to school for to be a neuroscience. That was his field of study. He was going for his PhD in neuroscience. What is neuroscience? Whew, that's some heavy stuff, man. That's like Mangerian candidate, stuff. When you mess with nerve and brain and hypnotism and stuff like that. Powerful, powerful stuff. Was this guy a rogue or a Mangerian candidate? Possibly. He was involved. He was living and working and going to school in a state where the CIA, the FBI, and all these key intelligence agencies are there. Yeah. What's coming up? The UN gun treaty. Whew, man. This is like in the loom of the UN gun treaty. You don't think they're going to use that? Use this, what happened, as an isolated event to enforce the withdrawal of law-abiding citizens. Come on, you guys. This stuff was orchestrated. I'm telling you guys, you don't have to be... This is so orchestrated. This was supposed to happen, and it was executed with military prestige. You know how many smartphones are out there? My 11-year-old son has a smartphone. And nobody has video pictures of what happened? What? Nobody took video of... that just boggles my mind. It boggles my mind. Last week, there was another... A law-abiding citizen, which pulled off a heroic act that saved lives. His name was Samuel Williams. 70-year-old Samuel Williams was in an internet cafe in Florida. I believe it was Florida. Where two bank robbers came in. One was armed with a bat. Idiot. And the other one was armed with a gun. Well, this 70-year-old cat pops up and shoots the robber, preventing further loss of life. He was a concealed carry holder. He had his concealed CCW, concealed carry permit. Now he, within seconds, reacted. He drew, he fired, and he stopped the assailants. Heroic man. Heroic man. He's 71 years old. 71. How many people were injured at the theater or were shot? 71. So there you have the numerology. There you have the numbers. 71-year-old man uses his law-abiding right, his Second Amendment right, and stopped maybe deaths or... He was a hero. Now, what happens now? This guy goes, student dropout goes crazy in the movie theater. Now, I don't care. People say, well, the reason why people didn't get involved because he's wearing body armor. Now, I don't know what body armor he had, but I'll tell you this right now. If you get shot anywhere in that body armor, in close quarters, it will drop you. I don't care if it's a 9mm or if it's a 40. If you get hit with a bullet and you're wearing any type of vest, it will drop you to your knees. Now, anybody who's been through the CCW course, they don't just go through it and you just get a flying by card where you just, okay, you're good to go. No, they have to ensure that you can draw your weapon and place well shots. Well-placed shots. Anybody with within that area who would have been armed would have been able to take him down. Now, nobody likes getting shot at. I don't care who you are. I don't care who you are, nobody likes getting shot at. However, if people are dying left and right, and this guy obviously had to make a couple of mag dumps, how come nobody in Colorado that's a CCW didn't draw? Those movie theaters, any movie theater you go into, they don't have metal detectors. It isn't a no gun allowed facility. But no, there's something more to this than meets the eye, you guys. It just stinks to high hell. Is it tragic that all these people got shot and people died and lost their lives? Yes. Yes. But people who orchestrate this stuff don't care about human life. You can look back at any war fought, 9/11, Columbine, and all these shootings. You would think that the state would promote law-abiding citizens to take their CCW courses, concealed carry courses, so they can arm their civilians, so that stuff like this will be prevented, won't happen. Anybody who has a CCW, who has a have you ever met one? They're law-abiding citizens, man. They're not these gun-toting cowboys that the companies that these corporates are, that the government plays on them to be. They're not vigilantes. They're law-abiding citizens, ready to defend and protect themselves and others. Why not arm the general population, man? Virginia Tech. If those students were armed, that cat would have went down. Does it make you wonder how so much death could be caused by just one gunman? In all these incidents where these shooters, these armed guys go on this rampage, they obviously have to make a couple of magazine dumps. But yet, they're by themselves, and they could cause so much damage. It just boggles my mind, man. When you're in combat and you're in a fire team, it takes every individual in that fire team to play a part to have an effective, maximum effectiveness. Because a lone gunner, a lone shooter, cannot cover every avenue of approach. It's just physically impossible, because we only have two eyes. So you physically can't control every avenue of approach. And this guy, I guarantee you, doesn't have any military experience. But yet he's able to take down 71, inflict 71 casualties. People got 71 got hurt. That's just amazing. There isn't one guy, one man, or woman who wouldn't take charge and be like, dude, people are dying. Look at, he's going for a magazine dump. Let's take him out. Say they didn't have they weren't armed. They didn't have a gun. There isn't one person that would be like, hey, this guy's making a magazine dump, let's get him. I don't know, it just boggles my mind. Boggles my mind that this guy would go in there and inflict so much, just one man. And that there wasn't any concealed carry holder or combat vet that wouldn't activate, that wouldn't get involved. It just boggles my mind. People say, well, he had body armor. So what? That doesn't make you immoral. That doesn't make you immortal. You can body armor only protects so much, you guys. And in close quarters, if you get shot in the chest or in the back with body armor, you will be dropped. It's not like a ding. Oh man, well, no, you will be dropped. But you know, this stinks of high hell. But I just think that was funny that he was going for his PhD in neuroscience. That's just wow. You don't think that has anything to do with it? And then like change the channel. He was saying how this guy had his whole apartment or house booby trapped, but yet he was cooperating with authorities. They say he wasn't cooperating with the authorities, but he told the police when they got him about how his place was rigged and booby-trapped. When this guy went in a theater and shot women and children and people, just he had no discretion. He was just a killing machine. But he's gonna tell the law, okay, wait, you guys, be careful, because my place is rigged. Don't want any of you getting killed or anything like that. What? All of a sudden his conscience kicks in? Bullshit! You know, it's like that massacre in, that happened last year, or earlier this year in, I don't know where it was, you guys, that one guy, I forget, I don't know if it was in Switzerland or where it was, but he went to this island where this summer camp, or maybe it was last year, where there was a summer camp and he just went on a killing spree again by himself in riot gear, and he just went killing all these kids. By himself, went killing all these kids. Nobody took video or pictures of any of that either. But, you know guys, I'm just saying, this guy, he was a known Freemason. He went down without a fight. He didn't lose his life. Just like this guy in this movie theater, killed all these people and police don't drop him. It just amazes me that this guy could do so much killing and no one drops him. Nobody drops this guy. He would go for magazine dump and no one drops him. Now, I don't know how Colorado works and operates, but here in Cali, in California, maybe it's just the movie theaters I go to, but there's police at the movie theaters. They patrol the movie theaters. Police, PDs patrol the movie theaters. Now you have the opening premiere of Batman Dark Knight, and there wasn't any police near that movie theater when there's known going to be a huge number of people going to this premiere. There isn't any crowd control, armed law enforcement providing crowd control, monitoring the parking lots, making sure there isn't any fights. Nah, man. Nah. Here in California, movie theaters are patrolled by law enforcement. Armed. Especially at a premiere where there's going to be lots of people, and the movie is a violent movie. Oh yeah, there will be police there, making sure people don't come out of the movie theater thinking they're Batman and start fighting or be a vigilante. I'm telling you guys, this is all symbolic. But thank you to N7777 and Photo Helix and the Haas USMC and Change the Channel and all these other guys that are bringing light to this subject, because you guys, the people up there, they want to demonize guns. Now they have the UN treaty. I'm telling you, reality is going to kick in real soon. It's going to get real, real quick. The 27th is right around the corner, you guys. The UN is going to try to disarm America. I'm telling you guys. And you know what, you guys? There's going to be a lot of death. A lot of death. I guarantee it. You don't think that's part of the depopulation? All right, you guys, I got cut off again. But what I was saying is Americans aren't going to go down without a fight. No way. No way. And the people up there know that. So that's helping them out with the depopulation and you know, killing. That's all they want is just to kill. Now I made a YouTube video a while ago about the UN and about an animated short video. Go on my video of my uploads and I talk about the UN video or something like that, and it talks about the disarmament of America. You guys, the UN is they are the people running the global agenda for new world order. The UN is behind it because they're not governed and dictated by anybody. Now they have the gun treaty, yes, and there's a video, I forget who shared that video about the article that was dated 1961, I think, or 1967, something like that, about the UN's agenda to disarm America for a peaceful world. Well, you guys, mankind cannot bring peace. Mankind cannot bring peace because there's some sick, dark, and evil people out there that are just sick, dark, and evil people. whether you take a gun away or whatnot, they're going to kill and they're going to be evil. Now this guy went on this rampage at the movie theater. He had CS. He had gas canisters, gas grenades. Okay. He was using tear gas to cause a stir. Now why don't they ban tear gas? How did he get tear gas? What? Why don't they ban that? No, they're not gonna do that. They're not gonna demonize CS gas or gas grenades. No way. They're going after the guns. But if he went in there and he was armed with a pair of scissors or a knife and he starts slashing and dashing and stabbing everybody, what are they going to do? Put a ban on knives or scissors? No, they're not going to do that. They're going to demonize guns because that's our Second Amendment. This happened for a reason. And tragically, people lost their lives. And my thoughts and prayers go out to all the victims and family and friends of those people who lost their lives. But this is the beginning, man. It's going to get real, real quick. Reality's going to set in real quick. I'm telling you, within the next 2 weeks, you guys, next week, and 2 weeks, you guys, there's going to be a lot of stuff happening, man. I'm not spreading fear or anything like that, but I'm telling you guys right now, arm yourself and have a plan. Because these people, all these young soldiers, sailors, and Marines who are combat veterans, you know, when we're downrange, what do we do? We go kicking in doors and we look for weapons traps, small arms. Doesn't it sound like training? Second nature. These door kickers, it's second nature. Boom! Clear room, look for weapons traps. Professionals at it. You guys, wake up, man, because it's gonna get real, real quick. It's gonna get real, real quick. And if you're one of those people who demonize, you know, people who own firearms, oh man. When they come for the guns in America, people are gonna flock to, hey, do you know anyone who has guns? They're going to look for gangsters. They're going to go to thugs. Please. If you can give me any gun, I pay the highest price. Just give me a gun. Oh, yeah. Gangsters and thugs are going to be the preppy square. The preppy square's go-to guy. Please help me get a gun and defend myself. Oh yeah, man. So, I just wanted to share my thoughts and opinions on that, you guys. This sad and tragic thing that happened in the movie theater. A lot of symbolism behind that, you guys. From the movie, to the theater, to the time, location, the guy doing all this. Makes you really want to question what's really going on here. One lone gunman in a close quarters environment in a state where there's law-abiding citizens that are armed. Shoots 71 people and then doesn't resist. It just gives up or whatever. Police take him into custody. This guy lives and then he goes and tells police, oh, be careful when you go to my place because it's all booby trapped. And like, what? You didn't give a crap about life, but now you care about cops? What? There's just so many things about this. This guy is a nerd. I mean, you guys, I'm not gonna repeat myself. Just educate yourself, guys. There's more to it than you just think. And the media is all over it. Why are they all over Samuel Williams? Why isn't the media covering that story? Man, I would be like, dude, people gotta hear about this. This 71-year-old man stops an internet robbery that was occupied by so many people. He used his Second Amendment and his well-trained. Why didn't the media give him praise and honor him for that? Because we know who controls the media. Well, take care, you guys. I'm sorry I went on and on, but I had to express my views and opinions on this. Arm yourself, you guys. Get some trigger time. Train, and prepare yourself. But remember, guns and rifles are tools. They're tools, you guys. Even if you don't have a gun or a rifle or a shotgun or whatever, have a plan and have the mental strength to endure. Because the most powerful weapon on this planet is right here. The most powerful weapon is your brain. So, brains before bullets. But I'll tell you right now, arm yourself. Take care, you guys. Much love. Thanks for all continued love and support. Thumbs up, favorites, comments, views. I'm appreciative, you guys. I thank you. So take care. Much love. I'll see you next video. And remember, you guys, it doesn't matter what happens around you. But what matters is what happens with you. Much love. Take care.